This is really about diversification, particularly in such a politically volatile time.
Yeah, that's right. We speak so much about that China plus one strategy. You're either looking at shifting operations away from China, or you're just looking to invest directly into economies that are perhaps more stable from that geopolitical perspective. And Southeast Asia is really the key beneficiary in this because it's got low labor costs, or relatively low labor costs, a lot of tech talent, close to major consumer markets as well. But this is that latest iteration of China plus one. The deal that you mentioned there is between the Dutch chipmaker NXP, like you mentioned, also Vanguard as well, which I was just taking a look earlier at the ownership structure. It's just under 30% owned by TSMC, so very much the biggest shareholder there. But the investment, as you said, just under that $8 billion mark, so $7.8 billion, and it's going to be about building new chip wafers, not perhaps the most technologically advanced chips out there, but they're still really important for things like powering, controlling cars and mobile devices as well.
And Bell, this is not the first time that these companies have actually teamed up in Singapore.
Yeah, and that's one of the reasons that we heard, for instance, from the CEO of NXP earlier talking about why they chose again to take this route in Singapore in particular, because actually NXP had a joint venture with TSMC that started back at the end of the 90s when it was still under the Philips brand. So yes, as you said, that was part of that decision. But what is important to note as well is that this new facility is actually going to have the most cutting edge technology. So what Vanguard's, for instance, doing right now in Singapore, they're producing chip wafers that are 8 inches in diameter. This one's going to be 12 inches in diameter, so about 30 centimeters. So you're basically putting more chip output per wafer.
You know, tiny but mighty, that's the Singapore economy, right? But there is so much focus on future-proofing this reputation. This is a bit of a coup for the new leader, Lawrence Wong.
Yeah, well, as we're discussing, Lawrence Wong has just taken leadership there, new prime minister, and a lot of different challenges that are on his plate. He's got things like a cost of living crisis, he's got geopolitical challenges, but also really stiff competition within the region here, within Southeast Asia. And you take a look at semiconductors in particular, they're a really key part of Singapore's exports. And just last week, actually, when I was in Singapore, I was speaking with a senior minister of state about why the country has a distinct competitive advantage, things like a well-trained workforce, a good supporting ecosystem, but there are still competitors. And Malaysia, of course, is just over the border, and we've seen a lot of investment going into Johor in particular from the likes of Nvidia, Intel as well, a ByteDance-owned company, and as well in Malaysia looking to put about $5 billion into attracting chip designers. But Malaysia, Vietnam, Thailand, they're really all looking for the same sort of investment here.